Yo, what's up, y'all? Welcome to episode 8 of Plug Talk Tuesdays. And let's go. So, on episode 7, we talked about assets, right? And assets are essentially anything that you have in your possession. It doesn't necessarily have to be something that you own, but something that you have that can make you more money. It also is something that allows you to make passive income while you're asleep. And it's something that works for you while you're out doing whatever it is that you want to do. You're able to make money without actively having to participate in whatever function that is. And I also want to mention this. You get to define what an asset is. Don't let anybody else tell you what an asset is. You can allow your creativity, gifts, and skills make assets out of nothing. I'm out here in Mexico right now and I'm watching people make assets out of coconut, assets out of jet skis, assets out of sand and shells and all types of stuff. Reason being is they're taking their gifts and their talents and they're putting it to work in order to make something that becomes now more valuable because they put their time into it. So you get to decide, what is an asset for me? What is something? What is a gift? What is a skill? What is a talent that I have that I can put effort in that's gonna make me more money in the long run? And you have to remember, there's levels to this. Not all assets are created equal, and not all assets will make you the same amount of money, and not all assets require the same amount of effort put into them. So that's why you have to define what type of assets you want to spend your time with and spend your time investing in. But you also have to remember this, you have to start somewhere. Just like any other area in life, you need to be able to gain the confidence to do what it is that you want to do. Asset building is no different. So starting out with something small and then working your way up allows you to build the confidence to get bigger assets, to expand the amount of zeros that you're working with. But if you don't have the confidence to be able to do it because you didn't put in the reps, it doesn't matter. You're not going to be able to execute when the numbers and the dollars get bigger. You're not going to want to take that risk because you haven't built up the confidence within yourself to do that. So my encouragement to you is start right where you're at with what you have. What gifts, talents, skills can you use right now to leverage to build up your confidence so that way you can start to get into the asset acquisition game and allow yourself to level up as you grow? I want you to remember this. Any asset worth having and keeping will be hard to acquire. So here's what I want you to remember. Here's the takeaway for today. The term hard. Having assets requires discipline. Okay, hear me again when I say this. Having assets requires discipline. Reason being is because whatever you do, whether you start small with lower numbers and lower trade-off when it comes to sowing and reaping, and then you start to work your way up to the bigger numbers, it doesn't matter. If you want to have an asset that's going to bring value to your life and wealth to your life and your generation and your legacy, it's going to require discipline. No asset worth having is going to come without exercising discipline. I promise you that. And you may think, how does discipline, what does discipline have to do with any of this? It has everything to do with this. Because with discipline comes patience. And when I'm disciplined and I have patience, I understand that there's a process. Any asset worth having is going to require me to be patient with the process, patient with myself, patient with others, because more times than not, your asset is going to require you to have to deal with other people. So that means I have to exercise patience. Fun fact, it took me 52 days to close on my duplex. 52 days. That joint required patience and discipline. It was a brutal process that I couldn't wait for it to be over. But there was nothing I could do. I had to let the process be the process. So during that time frame, I had to make sure that I focused on my focus. I had to stay disciplined. I had to make sure I didn't shift my finances too much. I had to make sure that I was still learning the real estate game. I had to make sure that I was still invested in this. But on the other side of it, now I still have to be disciplined with maintaining the property, with making sure that everything aligns up, with making sure that I'm in communication with my property managers and my tenants. So even though it's a passive investment, it takes hard work and discipline to get it, and it takes hard work and discipline to keep it, and to make sure that it still is worth it at the end of the day. So here's a question I want you to ask. How hard are you willing to work? How disciplined are you willing to be? How patient are you willing to be to see yourself grow and acquire assets? Because that's what this is about, right? It's about asset accumulation. So if I'm going to have multiple different assets, I got to have major discipline and patience. Because if you don't have major discipline and patience, all your assets are eventually going to plummet because you don't have the discipline and the patience and the reps and the confidence to even keep up with them in the first place. So remember, having assets requires discipline. And the reason why this is so important is because you reap what you sow. If you want your asset to make money for you, if you want your asset to grow, and you want your asset to grow your wealth, then you need to make sure you're sowing discipline into it. You're sowing time into it. You're sowing good things in it so you can get good things back out of it. Because at the end of the day, you want prosperity. You want your assets to prosper in the long run, and you want them to prosper beyond you. Because what could happen is you can acquire an asset, if we're talking real estate specifically, and then you don't continue to do your due diligence and make sure you're handling your systems right, you could lose it. And then what? Now you're not able to continue to grow generational wealth. Now you lost it. Maybe you passed it down to one generation and then they lose it because you didn't teach or show them what does it mean to be disciplined with your assets. What does it mean to be disciplined with your gifts? And so this is something that goes beyond you. You should be wanting to sow a legacy of discipline that goes along with your assets as well. The last thing I'm gonna say is another point when it comes to assets is getting in the stage of overflow. Discipline allows you to get into stages of overflow with your assets that cover your lifestyle. I'm recording this video right now in Mexico, all paid based off of my assets. Nothing from my W-2 income. How beautiful is that? That's the whole point of having assets, is so that way you can live the life that you want from another source that doesn't deplete another source. But you have to be disciplined in order to get to that level to make sure you can live the lifestyle that you want, because you reap what you sow. And I promise you, if you sow discipline into any area of your life, you will see positive fruits of patience come from your sowing of discipline. So don't forget it. Having assets requires discipline. And I promise you, discipline may not feel good in the moment, but the joy of it will last for a lifetime. So take the time to figure out what is it that you want to engage in? What area, what asset are you willing to be disciplined for in order to reap the benefits from it? Thank you so much for tuning in. Plug Talk Tuesday. I'm Coach Reese. Let's grow.